Now, this may be a slight repeat here, but as you can see, I have two different cables. It just so happens they're different colors. And they run to the front end of my two interfaces, hardware interfaces. Over here, you have the NCE USB terminal interface. Here you have Locobuffer. For the Digitrax system, as in the manual, you'll go ahead and open up the Locobuffer shell, and then you're going to want, to set this to be a terminator. And that's all in the instructions. Now, both of those go to the Digitrax, obviously goes to this one, the Locobuffer, and then I have my main control here. And then the Digitrax, this, I will show you this time instead of just writing it out. This has its own power supply, this UP5 panel, and that's right there. Now, for the SE8c, which is this one right here, note I did put both of these in the front. Apparently it does matter in order to get power over Locobuffer. Someone correct me if that's wrong, but it didn't like it when both of them were in the back. Anyway, so going over here with my shaky camera work, don't we all love it? I have the Digitrax SE8c board here, and obviously I have the cable running to it. One thing I'll point out here in the 44-pin connector is I have two wires soldered onto it going to a terminal strip. I don't have anything else on it right now because I'm not going to use anything else, but beside the point. These wires go to this, which follow this cable, which eventually leads to another power source. That's right, the SE8c needs its own power supply. Specifically, it needs a 12-volt AC. Not DC. You can do a 15-volt DC or a 12-volt AC. I was, even though the directions don't want you to use a power supply that's powering anything else, these, as you can see, well, they look the same, but they're DC. They output DC power. So that is one thing you will want to watch. And then another thing I'll just point out in this video is I use the Digitrax ribbon cable. You can use regular old, really cheap 10-pin cable or 12-pin cable. I'll put it in the video what this actually is. I'm pretty sure it's just 10-pin ribbon cable. And all you need to know is pin 1, as I've explained in previous videos. But since I'm not running it that far, I was able just to pick up two of the SDC case. Pardon my shaky camera work. I know you guys and myself don't like it. Now, one thing I will tell you is in the instructions, this says it makes two cables with connections for up to 4 signal heads. As of right now, because I didn't use the signal mast, instead I used the terminal strips, I actually made more. I got more signal heads on the system. To be more precise, I got 2. Let me see. 4. 5, 6. The searchlight here will be number 7. So I got about 7 signal heads on the rip out of that one package, because the difference between the mast here is it's going to be soldered on. So what it's assuming is you'll need more of the connecting, the crimps. It's assuming you'll need one for the board, one for the mast that has 2 signal heads, and then 2 for each diverging single signal head. But because I'm using, like I said, the terminal strip, I can just plug 2 of these in. Thereby, 1 of these to plug into the SE8c board, and then 2, 1 for each one of these. And then as I showed you, each one of these screw terminals, each one of these separate sets is its own address, which is on the SE8c signal board, and I will be, repetitive. And tell you the way it works is each one of these plants has four addresses. And then that's controlled on how you connect the, one, how you wire the, signal.